In this video, we're going to create a topography using create topography from import. So let's go to massing and site, topo surface, create from import, select import instance. You can click once on the AutoCAD file, and you can select the layers of the AutoCAD file that you want the topography to be based on. I'm guessing it's based on the three layers, which is start by CVL. So let's start it. Okay, that seems about right. You can modify the points or something, but I'm just gonna go ahead and finish the surface. So as you can see here, the topography is created. We'll take care of the levels later. Now we can take care of the settings a little bit. If you select the topography, you can assign material here, and I'm going to show you how this material is different than if you go to massing and site tab and use the site settings over there. Okay, so let's start with this one. If I select this topography here, I can assign material from here. Usually the material of the surface can be like grass or something, but the material inside should be soil, right? So I'm gonna see if we have any grass material here. Otherwise we can create it. It's not there. Create new material. Rename it as grass, earth, or something like that. You can go to the asset browser and search for grass material. We have a lot of grass here. I'll select one of them. Okay, you can close this one. The grass is assigned. As usual, I want to change the graphics to be able to follow the materials easier later. Yeah, this is good. Okay. And okay. Now the material is grass. If I change this to like shaded, you can see that green color that I assigned to the graphics. I'll change it back to, actually let's leave it like this. I'm gonna show you how you can take a section box here. Under the properties of the view, you can see the section box. Remember, when nothing is selected, the properties is showing the properties of the 3D view or of the view which is active. You can check the box for section box. You can select the edge of the section box, move it forward to see what's going on below the surface of the ground. As you can see, the material here is different, and it's actually soil material. It's different than the material at the top, right? Change back to hidden line, and if you zoom in, you can see that the surface has also a pattern of soil. So it's interesting. You see that we assigned grass at the top, but automatically this part is set to be on soil. How does it work? What about if I go to massing and site and click on the site settings? You can see that the section graphics actually reads the information from here, right? So the section cut material is now earth. If you want to change that, you can click here, and you can see the earth is here. The appearance is like this. The graphics is like this. Now let's work on the graphics a little bit. We can change the color to some other color if you wish. And notice that the foreground has a pattern, right? So it means that the foreground pattern, the earth pattern, is going to override the color, so we're going to have the color in the background. Okay, so that's good. I'm going to say okay, apply, okay. So if you zoom in, you can see that we have both the pattern and one color in the background. And this whole thing, the material that you see in the section is different than the material that you see at the top. Okay, You can leave the section box, or you can remove it by clicking the check mark here. There are a couple more settings that you can take care of by going to the site settings thing here. If you want to have a denser or less dense set of topography, you can change the intervals from here and from there. Like if I go with 2 rather than 5, actually it didn't change from here. How about I'll change this back to 5, but I change this from 1 to 2, it's going to be less dense, right? If you want it to be really dense, you can go with 1.1 or something, but I'm going to leave it on 2. I'm going to apply it, and I'm going to go with OK. In the next video, I'm going to show you how you can create street surfaces based on 2D lines for the streets, and how to overlap it with the surface of the topography.